George Louis Boots. So here we are going with the next interview, which has been given as a topic for you. And I have already told you the lesson name is "I believe that books will never disappear." This is an interview which is with George Louis Boots, who is the author. And here we come across the interview which has been conducted with George Louis Boots from one of the journalists by the name Robert Alfano. Regarding George Louis Boots, this author whom we are talking about, he is an Argentinian short story writer. Not only a short story writer, he is also an essayist, he is a poet, and he is also a translator, born in Buenos Aires. And his work embraces the characters of reality in all literature. His most famous books are Fisiones, which was in 1944, and Alpha, which was in 1949, which are a collection of short stories interconnected with common themes, including dreams, labyrinths, libraries, mirrors, infinity, fictional writers, philosophy, religion, and God. And regarding Albert Elfino, the journalist, he was not only a journalist, he was also a poet, storyteller, he was also an essayist. And he was born in the city of General Pinto, the province of Buenos Aires, and he was born in 1943. His books have been translated into several languages. And from 1974 to 1985, he worked with George Louis Boots. So he also worked for George Louis Boots. So children, we have got introduced to the author George Louis Boots, and Robert Alfano, who conducts the interview of George Louis Boots, is Robert Alfano. So this interview, what we are going to go through today, is in between the journalist and the author. And before that, we are going to go with the pre-reading activity which has been given here. So the pre-reading activity, what we are going to go through, is first one is, what is the difference between an interview and a chatting episode? So we have to understand what is an interview. So an interview is a meeting of people face to face for consultation. So an interview is always conducted between people. So interviews are conducted when we go to higher studies. So if I want a seat in a very good college, I just have to go through, I may be called for an interview where my capacity is tested there, whether I am eligible for this particular seat. Or if I have put for a job, I have to face an interview where the organization where I want to work will conduct an interview where my capacity, whether I am able to go through the job or not, is conducted through the through an interview where, if they are satisfied, they will give the job for me. Or in an interview, if I am worth enough, I'll be getting a seat in one of the colleges. So this is an interview, which is usually a meeting of people face to face for consultation, so that whether we are capable of getting a job or an interview, like that. Other, we have got other interviews also. Now chatting is talking a friendly way, friendly and informal way of chatting is an friendly and informal way of talking between two friends. It's a chatting doesn't have a particular method of having. So it's a very friendly way of talking with each other, a friendly way of having chatting with talking with your friends, where it doesn't have a boundary itself. So you can just chat. So usually friends will just, how much you are talking will be telling, either it may be in a phone or in a mobile. We see, or we may see two of them go on sitting and talking. So there is no particular topic as such. They can just go on talking whatever they want, and it's a very friendly talking, which is called as chatting. And like that only, think of different situations where people are interviewed. The second question is, think of different situations where people are interviewed. For example, job or for enrollment to a course, etc. So I have already given an example for a job. So if I want to get after my degree course, so when I finish my engineering, I would like to go and get a job. So when I want a job, I apply for a company where the company calls me for an interview. So when I go to the interview, I'll be asked some of the questions face to face, where I have to answer them, and if they are satisfied, I'll be getting the job. So it is something like that. And not only that, it for me, and if I want a seat where I would like to go to one of the best colleges, to get a seat in a best college, usually there is an interview, not only a written test, even an interview is conducted, whether I am fit enough to go through this, fit enough to be given this seat in that college. So my capacity, my intelligence is tested there. That is also an interview. How does it vary from situation? So situations are different here. I want a job. Job circumstance is very different. Situation is very different. An interview only, it is for the sake of a job, where I get a job. After finishing my completion of my degree, that is an interview, a situation which is very different. And when I want a seat in a very good college, that situation is different, where I will be asked or I'll be interviewed whether I'm fit enough to be getting that seat in that college. So there are different way of different situations where the interview is conducted. So these are the two things what I have answered you, the difference between an interview where different situations are there, chatting which is only between two friends or with friends where there is no particular method of having at the talk. It may be a friendly talk, it may be within whatever you want to discuss, or just sit and chat with your friend. Now children, let me go with the lesson now. So the interview starts with both of them. So now Robert Alfano, who is the journalist, he is the journalist who is taking the interview of George Louis Borges, and he starts taking the interview now. The first question Robert Alfano asks is, what was your first literary reading, Borges? He says, come on, tell me, which was the first book you read, and what was your first literary reading? Borges. And Borges answers, see, I believe my first reading was Grimm's Fairy Tale in an English version. I was educated by my father's library, perhaps more than by high school or university, he says. See, when the question is asked, which is your first literary, which was the first literary book you read? And here Borges answer, see, I believe my first reading was Grimm's Fairy Tale. The fairy tales are the children's pleasure to read them. So usually children go through the fairy tales where many imaginary characters are there. They love to see many of these. They love to read such books, the fairy tales, where many things happen without any of the doubts here. So fairy tales, and he says it, the Grimm's Fairy Tales was a and that was in an English version. In an English version, he had gone through, and he says, I was educated more by my father's library, because it had such a huge collection of books where I could just go with my I was educated by my father's library, which had a collection of lot of books where I was able to go through, perhaps more than any of the high schools or university. I got my education in my father's library, he says. And Alfano, he questions him, can we talk about Donna Leonora, your mother? Come on, let us question now. The next question what he asks is, he asks Bose, Bose, can you tell me about Donna Leonora, about your mother? And Bose, George Louis Bose answers, he has got his own imagination of his, I mean, his experience, his way of telling about how his mother was. Now, Bose goes on telling, my mother was an extraordinary person, he says. So, like all mothers, my mother was not like that. She was an extraordinary person. I should speak above all of her kindness towards me. She was not only my mother, she was extraordinary than any other mother. Not only that, she was too kind towards me. She was such a kind person towards me. And I'll tell you a secret of mine, he says. See, I'll just tell you a secret which I didn't tell anybody till now. I feel somewhat guilty for not having been a happy man in order to have given her a deserved happiness. I feel guilty, perhaps I should have been more understanding of her. But I do not know, I suppose, that it is true of all children. When our mothers die, we feel that we have taken her for granted, as we do with the moon or sun or the seasons. We feel we have abused her. Before her death, it doesn't dawn on us. My mother was an intelligent, gracious woman who I believe had no enemies. So altogether, what we come to know, he talks beautifully about his mother. He says that she was an extraordinary person, and he tells that I would like to tell my secret of mine, because I feel guilty, perhaps, because I should have been more understanding of my mother when she was alive. I couldn't understand at all. I took her for granted. Like all mothers, all children, they take, when their mothers are alive, we take our mother's love and affection as granted. She is doing a mother's duty, nothing more. And we think it is our right that she is doing like that. She is loving us. She is giving a care for us. She is giving extra care because she is my mother. That much only we think about her. But I know, suppose that is true of all children. When our mothers die, when we lose our mothers, when we lose our mother completely, that is when she dies, we feel that we have taken her for granted, as we do with the moon or sun or the seasons. See, sun and moon, we take it for granted. Morning happens and night comes. So morning the sun rises and night we see the moon. So here, that is taken for granted. What is so great? Every day we have got a morning, every day we have got a night. So it is taken for granted.